Let's continue with multiple choice questions. Which of the following does not show optical isomerism? A part will show optical isomerism because it has bidentate ligand. B part will show geometrical isomerism. Geometrical also it will show facial and meridional isomerism. It cannot show optical isomerism. This complex will show optical isomerism because there are bidentate ligands, but its cis form will show, transform will not. This will show optical isomerism because there is one bidentate ligand. So the correct answer is B part. B part will show geometrical isomerism but not optical isomerism. The IUPAC name of this complex is, these are the options. Now correct answer is tetraamine nickel 2 tetrachloridonickelate 2. C part is the correct answer. The IUPAC name of this complex, sodium cobalt nitrite is the common name. Sodium hexanitrito N cobaltate 3 is the correct IUPAC name. Sodium hexanitro cobalt 2 is not the correct name. Sodium hexanitrito cobaltate 3 is not correct. B part is the correct answer. Sodium hexanitrito N cobaltate 3. Why cobaltate? Because complex ion is negatively charged. 3 is the oxidation state, plus 3 plus x minus 6 equal to 0. X comes out to be plus 3. These two complexes are given and we have to find out whether it is geometrical isomerism, position isomerism, optical isomerism or identical. Correct answer is they are identical. Because E and R on opposite side, A are on opposite side, so both are identical. Next, ammonia forms the complex ion CuNH3 4 times 2 positive with copper ion in alkaline solution, but not in acidic solution. What is the reason for it? In acidic solution, hydration protects copper ions. Second option, in acidic solution, protons coordinate with ammonia molecules forming NH4 positive ion and ammonia molecules are not available. This is the correct answer. Because in acidic medium, ammonia gets protonated and ammonium ion cannot act as a ligand. That is the reason that this complex will not be formed in acidic solution. C part is not correct because copper hydroxide cannot be formed under these conditions. And copper hydroxide is an amphoteric substance is also not correct. It is basic. So B part is the correct answer. Next, among the following complexes, we have to find out diamagnetic complexes. Options are given. Now the correct answer is C part. Why? Because here cobalt is plus 3, 3d6, all electrons are paired, no unpaired electron, so it is diamagnetic. After that, third, oxalate ion will cause all electrons paired, so cobalt 3d6, all electrons are paired. Then we have fifth, here platinum is in plus 2 oxidation state, cyanide is strong field ligand, so all electrons will be paired, no unpaired electron, it is diamagnetic. And sixth one, zinc plus 2 ions does not have any unpaired electrons, so it will always form diamagnetic complex. Next question, which are the following coordination entity, the magnitude of octahedral splitting energy will be maximum? Option A, B, C and D. Correct answer is D part because cyanide ion is strong field ligand. So greater the field strength of the ligand, more will be octahedral splitting energy. Select a true statement from the following for the metal carbon ions. The pi back bonding strengthens a metal carbon bond order as well as carbonyl bond order. Second part, the pi back bonding weakens MC bond order as well as carbon monoxide or carbonyl group bond order. The pi back bonding weakens MC bond order and strengthens carbon monoxide bond order. The pi back bonding strengthens MC bond order and weakens CO bond order is the correct answer. So D part is the correct answer. It strengthens metal carbon bond because it involves both sigma bond as well as pi bond. Weakens carbon monoxide bond order because lone pair of electrons are donated to metal bond. Vacant d orbital of metal, that's why its bond order weakens. Geometrical shape of the complexes formed by nickel ions, Cl negative, Cn ions, water respectively are. These are the various options. The correct answer is B part. Why B part? Because nickel ions with chloride ion will form tetrahedral complex. With cyanide ion, it will form square planar complex. And with water, it will form octahedral complex. With chloride ion, it will form sp3 hybridization, so tetrahedral. With cyanide ion, dsp2 hybridization, square planar. With water, it will form d2sp3 hybridization. With water is weak field ligand, so it will be sp3d2 hybridization, outer orbital complex, which will be octahedral and paramagnetic. So B part is the correct answer. 1 mole of complex compound CONH3 5 times Cl3 gives 3 moles of ions on dissolution in water. 1 mole of the same complex reacts with 2 moles of silver nitrate to give 2 moles of HCl. The structure of the complex is, correct answer is A part. It will give 3 moles of ions and with silver nitrate it will form 2 moles of HCl. The stability constant of complexes formed by metal ion with ammonia, cyanide, water and En are 10 to the power 11, 10 to the power 27, 10 to the power 15 and 10 to the power 8 respectively. This shows En is strongest ligand. Cyanide is strongest ligand. Values cannot predict the strength of ligand. All ligands are equally strong. Correct answer is B part. Cyanide is strongest ligand because the value of stability constant is highest, that is 10 to the power 27. So that clearly shows cyanide ion is the strongest ligand. Here we are given coordination number of chromium in 6, a complex ion as Cr with oxalate ion En and superoxide ion O2-. Its formula is given in terms of XYZ, the ratio of XYZ we have to find out. Whether it is 1 is to 1 is to 1 or 1 is to 1 is to 2 or 1 is to 2 is to 2 or 2 is to 1 is to 1. Correct answer is B part, because if it is 1, this will become minus 2. And if this is 1, this is neutral. And peroxide ion is minus 1. So minus 1 into 2 will become minus 2. So chromium is plus 3. So overall there will be minus 1 charge. Only B part satisfies correctly. Next one, a complex MA3X3 where A and X are unidentate ligand may give 2 geometrical isomers, 3 geometrical isomers, 2 geometrical isomers which can be resolved into pair of enantiomers, 2 geometrical isomers, one of which can be resolved into pair of enantiomers. Correct answer is A part, 2 geometrical isomerism. It cannot show optical isomerism at all, and the name of these geometrical isomerism will be facial and meridional. Which of the following statement is incorrect? In K3 FeCN6, the ligand has satisfied only the secondary valency of the ferric ion. In K3 FeCN6, the ligand has satisfied both primary as well as secondary valency of ferric ions. In K4 FeCN6, ligand has satisfied both primary and secondary valency of ferrous ions. In cupramine complex CuNH3 4 times sulfate, the ligand has satisfied only the secondary valency of the copper. Correct answer is A part. Ligand has satisfied only the secondary valency of ferric ions. Primary valency of ferric ion is satisfied by potassium ions. This is the incorrect statement. A part is incorrect statement because the ligand has satisfied both primary as well as secondary valency. Cyanide ion is satisfying the secondary valency and ferric is plus 3. So plus 3 and potassium counter ions are plus 3. So cyanide ions are satisfying both primary as well as secondary valency. Therefore this statement is incorrect. All other statements are correct. The ligand has satisfied both primary and secondary valency. Here also the ligand has satisfied both primary and secondary valency. Here the ligand has satisfied only the secondary valency because ligand is neutral and it can only satisfy secondary valency. Primary valency has to be satisfied by counter ions, that is sulfate ions.